In 2014, a new trend started to emerge. This documentary includes several interviews with individuals who were brave enough to speak out about their way of life. We asked interviewees what they thought about this new trend.
Are you going to try this?
Tried that about 2 years ago. Very down low, very behind closed door sort of thing. And I'll tell you what, the first time was a bit touch and go, but you get real used to it real quick. And then you start telling your friends about it, but you really got to feel them out first, because you don't want to just go and, you know, this new thing, and then like they're all like, whoa, what's going on? And then the opposite is you don't want them to get in on it as well, because it's kind of your thing. But it's just gonna take off so well, everyone's gonna be doing it soon.
So what are your friends saying?
Some of them are jealous, I can tell. If I had to take a vote, I'd say about 80% of my friends accept it, and they've actually encouraged me to not just do it at home. So I might actually try it in public, but I don't know if the world's ready for this. I think the only one that probably would disown me, probably my mom wouldn't be able to accept it. I don't know. Actually, I wonder what my dad would say. This isn't going online, right? Because if my mother sees this, she's going to kill me.
No.
No.
What do you think of the new trend yourself?
Right now, I think it's definitely something that's on the rise. Can't say right now at what point it's at, but I think more and more people by the day will be going for this look.
Do you think it's something that everyone can pull off?
Not really. No, I think it sort of will come down to your personality will be number one. I also think think about where you live before you start rocking this look. You don't want to be in the wrong neighbourhood with the wrong colours, because that could go wrong.
Meet Alex. She believes this new trend shouldn't only be limited to men.
So I'm really loving this new trend, and I just think that it's really creative. But at the same time, I'm kind of like, you know, why should guys just get all the fun? You know, when my boyfriend came home and he had, you know, everything all done, it was like, well, why can't we join in too, you know?
Essential to this new global trend is the ability to grow a beard. Meet Wayne. He's a motorcycle enthusiast.
You know, and wanted a beard ever since I was a small child. You know, used to have uncles that had beards and spent many happy hours swinging on them, and thought, wouldn't it be great when I'm an adult and I've got children at home that they could swing on my beard? So it was something I wanted to do for many, many years. And I unfortunately had to wait until puberty to grow a beard. But it was quite an interesting time, puberty, yeah.
This beard, it's taken about four months of not shaving. A little bit of white to show the wisdom. A little bit of orange to show there's no hate for the gingers. So that's where he came from. Oh, I love my beard. It keeps me warm at night. Yes.
Never really thought of it as a decorative thing. You know, I have plaited it at times, you know, the old Viking look. I'm not allergic to flowers. I quite like flowers. I've got nothing against them. Usually like to just give them away to the ladies, but I thought, you know, might just try that, dressing the beard up with a flower or two.
Wayne reveals his masterpiece.
And this is the full flower beard, you know, as opposed to the half flower beard, or as I prefer to call it, the flowery mow. There are actually tribes in the Amazon that still wear flowers in their beards and have done for thousands of years. It's actually a mark of masculinity amongst the tribes of the Amazon. It's a little known fact. I was once attacked by a swarm of bees, which is actually proved to be quite a painful experience. Couldn't get the flowers out fast enough, stung several times in the face, but I'm sure it was worth it for the bees. You know, they probably made a little bit of honey. But, you know, and in fact, the idea actually came to me when I was gardening one day. My wife said to me, can you tend to the flower beds? And the way she said it at the time, it was like, did she say flower beds or flower beards? And then I thought, hey, flower beds, there's a novel idea.
Whilst some have stumbled across the flower bed by accident, and the flower bed does date back to the 70s, Our research has led us to believe that the YouTuber Strugs Not Drugs may have been the reason for the new wave of the flower beds trending.
Hello, internetans. You may know me as Strugs Not Drugs, a former YouTuber, a reformed human being. I'm presenting this video to you today from Tibet as my flower bed damn well falls apart. But I want to express with you a new way of life that I've discovered out here in the woods. I needed to get away from the technology and the distractions of life. And I found the flower bed, the garden of the face, the freedom of the world, the friend maker of bees. And I have changed my name. It is now Malaika, and I am one with nature.
You know, in my opinion, I'd probably say less is more. I just find that some people kind of overdo it a little bit. But that's just me. I've recommended this to all my friends and they love it. So I just think go for it, really. Go for it. So I noticed that with your flower beard, you missed your moustache. Do you want to tell me?
See, in a garden, you don't just throw flowers everywhere and hope for the best. This is an exact strategic placement. It allows me to still appreciate everything around me and stop and smell. Oh, look at these flowers, you know, rather than my own arrangement sort of thing.
Do you get hay fever from this?
Not at all. I get a lot of hays, but no hay fever. My bed's one of those complicated canvases. It's a bit ginger, a little bit white, doesn't know what it's doing. So I feel that the flower configuration that I have today truly brings out the best in my beard.
We're going to tag along with Clint today as he takes his flower beard public for the first time.
Yeah, it's gonna be a challenge. And I'm just gonna pretty much see what happens. I go out there, show it off. I feel that there will be a lot of awkward stares, and I think there'll be people wanting to touch it and smell it. But weird. Well, what can you do? But you can always do the whole face forward and just ignore everyone. Those wolf whistles might get a bit annoying, but we'll just have to play it by ear. I think it'll give us a good feel to see if people are actually ready to accept flower beds.
Well, this is my old stomping ground, so I think that it's not many people here have seen me with a beard, let alone this. So I think I'm going to be quite safe, and I'm sort of in like a comfortable, familiar area, but I know that the people won't recognize me. This isn't going on the internet, right? So I'm safe, right? There's that fear of judgment, and it turns out the fear might be a little bit more overrated. You create the problem yourself versus, I think other people just look at him and go, what the hell, man? And they just say, okay, walk it off. It's actually quite a trend in Australia, and if I was an Aussie, I'd be walking around the beach, just hanging out like with my mates, and I'll just relax. I think New Zealand, it'll get there. I don't think I'm willing to accept the responsibility of starting that trend, just in case it's not accepted.
Call BMW.
What?
Josh has a particularly short beard, and Josh has been struggling to become accepted by his local flower beard group.
In the beard community, the flower beard community particularly, is there any segregation? I mean, is there like a ranking system on the flowers you wear, or?
Well, I think it all comes down to the individual, really. I don't think the size of the flower matters at all. I sort of more go for placement and whether or not, you know, fresh flowers are the best. Sometimes you see guys with these ones that are sort of half dead, hanging half off their face. It's not really the good look. Sort of just you know, the ones that look like they've just left the club at 6 a.m. For me personally, less is more, because I don't have as much beard as some guys. As a matter of fact, quite a few of my bros have been rocking the flower beards for a couple of years now. I've always thought it would suit me, but these are guys that are a bit further ahead of me in the in the facial hair department. So they're on the whole buzz that your beard needs to be a certain length or certain bushiness for you to be qualified to rock the flower beard. That sort of upsets me a little bit, because I don't feel that just because I've got the tidy short groomed beard that I should be left out of that circle. So I made a decision this week that I think I'll try rocking it, and I'll see what the bros think. Might lose friends over it.
How do you deal with like eating and with the flowers in your beard?
It's not too bad as long as they're edible ones, you know, as long as there's nothing in there that's actually toxic, it doesn't seem to have an effect. I have actually accidentally eaten the odd flower when I've been eating a meal, but as I say, you know, as long as they're not toxic, it's fine. Sometimes when I'm making a drink, I unintentionally make a cup of rosehip tea, the flower falls in, but it flavours it up, which is nice.
Straw spoon, so I can stir and drink my tea without disturbing the flowers.
The dog likes the flowers. They don't put her off at all. So the good thing about animals is they don't judge.
About access to flower hoarders, is there a group, like a underbelly of flower picking, or?
I think it's mainly you just go find what you can. I find in a lot of neighbourhoods there's a bit of a shortage now, because you know it's all dried up. People aren't letting the flowers grow. They're all picking them before they've reached their full potential. And then it's just depleted, so you might get guys going to other neighbourhoods trying to find more.
Are people protecting their flower beds, like their personal flower beds, or what?
I think a lot more now, especially for people that just like to have a flower garden. I think they've seen that it's a rising trend, so they've got to protect their flowers more.
What's the most extreme kind of protection that you've seen?
Probably pit bulls guarding like a rose bed.
The flower bed does come with some challenges and some prep required.
If I have to go with the smaller kind of flower, because it's a lot lighter, so it helps sticks in a bit easier. But it still wasn't helping. As soon as I moved or spoke, they'd come falling out. So I was just looking through my missus' makeup purse the other day and found this stuff called Duo, which is an eyelash adhesive. I know some guys using PVA glue, that sort of stuff. In the day, it's sort of, you know, not too good for your skin. Whereas this stuff dries clearly, and it also you can just wash it out the next day. I'm quite sure a few of the bros have tried a few things that hasn't worked out too well. But ever since I've been trying to join the club, you know, they haven't been letting me in on too many of their secrets. So that might change in the future, you know, once they accept the fact that, you know, I'll be rocking the style, they might let me in a bit more. Yeah.
First time I flowered up for a date, jumped on the motorcycle, went to head off into town to meet up with the lady for a few drinks and a meal, and when I got to town, of course, having ridden down the motorway, the petals had all been stripped off the beard, so all I was left with was just some stalks and a few little nubs. Wasn't really an attractive look, and that date didn't go too well, needless to say. I initially overcame the problem with the flowers falling out of the beard at speed on the motorcycle by gluing them in, but that also proved troublesome, as the beard flew back up and actually stuck to my nose at one stage. Made breathing a little difficult, and had to cut the beard off, which wasn't really that great, you know. It took a few weeks to grow back, but it's all good now, and you know, we learn from experience, so You know, now I use a combination of braiding and blue tack, which seems to work quite well for the motorcycle.
Is the Duro Glue that you're using, are you getting a better result with flower retention in your bed, or how's that going?
Definitely. I think it's it helps a lot more than not using any. It's not the natural way, but I mean anything that's safe that you can find that's only gonna help them stay in longer. It's just gonna help you to maintain your look a bit longer as well. So I definitely, even for guys with the longer beards that are more reliable at keeping the flowers in, I'd still recommend finding some sort of glue that you can use.
That's the view of those that are passionate about wearing flower beds, the friend maker of bees.